Well, all morning, our Angela Bishop has been taking us behind the scenes of the iconic soap Neighbours. Let's check back in with her now. She's in Erinsborough. Who have you found, Ange?
Well, I'm having such an amazing time on set here today because I just keep running into fabulous cast members and I just rip them out of a scene and get them for a chat. That's the kind of person I am and that's the kind of job I do. Olivia and Georgie join me now, current cast members, both sort of recruited pretty much out of school, wasn't it? Was that what it was for you, Olivia?
Yep, I was literally on a flight to schoolies and I got a call back. So I changed my flight, came back and did the audition.
Oh, yeah. And the Queensland economy's never recovered. But how exciting. How did you feel when you got that call?
I was so excited. At first they they were trying to figure out if I was too young or too old because I was supposed to play 15 and I was 18. They were like, maybe not. But finally they made the call, which was really exciting.
That is amazing. And Georgie, of course, your role is groundbreaking on so many levels. It must fill you with pride, but also it's significant on the part of the show too.
Absolutely right. And I mean, with Neighbours coming to a close right now and this celebration of the show, I'm just feeling really lucky to be a part of it and lucky to have played such, you know, an important character for a lot of people. And I feel like I did what I set out to do when I reached out to the producers when I was 17.
Tell us about that. How did it come about?
Yeah, so I was in my final year of school and I thought it'd be a really cool idea to have a trans character be on Neighbours. So I decided to write to the executive producer, Jason, pitched a character, basically talked myself into a job, and it worked. And 3 years later, I'm still here, and it's been awesome. It's been amazing.
And Mackenzie is the character that you created, and she has been on an incredible journey on the show.
Yeah, she has. She's been through the ringer, I'm really happy that we have a trans character on the show who isn't defined by her gender identity. She just exists and she gets to be a part of all the fun, silly, crazy stories just like any other character. Mm. So, yeah, it's been great.
It's about Neighbours reflecting the Australia, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I mean, all the parts of Australia.
Exactly. I think I remember Georgie's first day more than I remember my first day. And she came in and I was like, oh, my God, someone my age, yay. Yeah. And I was so excited. And it was we did a really big storyline together when she first started. Mm. And it was something quite powerful to be a part of. So, yeah.
Yeah, just amazing. So how are you feeling? It's only like two more days. Mm. What are the emotions like?
Well, it's like all the crew, I've been here for a while now, so is Georgie, and we're just like, can't quite believe it. I never thought it would come to an end. I remember my first year, we kind of were sceptical if it was going to end, and now it's finally happening, and we're just, I don't know, gobsmacked.
Georgie?
It's an incredibly bittersweet time. It's really beautiful because we get to celebrate the show and we get to come together and it's really uplifting. But it's really sad because I love working with everyone. They're really like a family. This is a second home. So it's really emotional as well.
Is there going to be one big rap party going on that I can crash?
Oh, I think so.
Yeah,
I think so. We know how to party.
Yeah, they do it well. They do it well. Every year I look forward to the rap party. Yeah. And this one will be really fun.
It will. And how do you think you'll feel when you watch those final episodes go to air in a few weeks' time?
I'm going to cry.
I'm already crying.
There's a lot of tears on set at the moment.
yeah. It's going to be, I keep saying it, it's going to be incredibly bittersweet, but I think the fans are going to love it. Yeah. We've put our heart and soul into these final episodes and I really hope everyone enjoys it.
Yeah. Are you two going to make a trip over to England after this? Is that the plan?
I actually am, but not on purpose. It wasn't because it was ending. I actually am though, so that'll be really fun. And I think it'll air kind of around the same time as when I'm there. So it'll be nice to see that.
Look out!
Yeah.
I would absolutely love to. I've got family in the UK, so and I think I've got some tickets to the UK that I was going to go, but then COVID happened, so I couldn't. But I think
everybody's got some of those.
Yeah, so I might pop over at some point later in the year. But yeah, I'd love to.
Yeah. Oh, well, it's been so wonderful to catch up with you both. Thanks for letting me drag you away from your scenes to talk to us on Studio 10.
It's been a pleasure.
And we'll see you on the big day on Friday when we do the whole OB from here.
Oh, exciting.
Yay!
Thanks,
see you later.
Girls.
Bye.
And I'll be back with more in a little bit. Like what you're seeing? Why not subscribe? And if you'd like to see more like this,
over here.